He's someone who I trust, someone who has a lot of wisdom, and also someone who I have a lot of fun with.
He's a great person, he's a caring person, and he's an awful golfer.
He is a man of integrity. He connects with people.
I asked our older son yesterday, actually, if you were to pick three words to describe your father, what would they be? Luke said he's a very good role model, reasonable and wise.
To me, he's someone whom I would consider a best friend.
Scott Smith, president of J.D. Smith & Sons and past chair of the OTA, grew up in Richmond Hill, Ontario, with much of his extended family. In fact, you can say he grew up in a community of family, which instilled the quintessential values of loyalty and respect that are evident in Scott today. Those family and business traditions were forged back to 1919, when at the outset of World War I, Scott's great-grandfather, John D. Smith, and his uncle started a freight cartage business with two trucks. In the 1950s, Scott's father, Doug Smith, took over the family fleet and warehouse business. Over the next 40 years, he established himself as a heavily respected voice at the OTA. He was elected chairman in 1985 and also became the recipient of the same Service to Industry Award. He could not know at the time that his son Scott would one day follow those same steps.
Doug was also an extremely hard worker, but he was a very dedicated man. And he was very dedicated to his family, to his business, to his employees, and also to the industry. I think Scott grew up around that.
He has a tremendous amount of respect for the people that came before him. And I think in his case, it's the family name and the legacy.
However, Scott's path into the family business wasn't predestined. As a teenager, he was a budding tennis player and went to school in Florida to play the game. He decided to return a year later and attended St. Andrew's College in Aurora. But eventually, Scott accepted his calling, and along with his brother Brian and sister Sue, they ensured the next generation would continue the family trucking legacy.
He's very involved, certainly within our company. He's very involved at the at the grassroots, at the driver level. He's a trucker. He's proud of that, and I hear him say that quite a bit when he's talking to people.
He took over the reins of the company in 1993, the same year he met his wife Kathy. Like most people who cross paths with Scott, she was charmed immediately.
I think the thing that I noticed very quickly with Scott was his kindness. It struck me. He was so kind, he was a great listener, and the other thing, of course, was his sense of humor. He's social, he's inclusive, he has great friends.
Scott understood at an early age that a strong OTA was essential for the future of the industry. As an up-and-coming executive, Scott was instrumental in bridging the generational gap of the aging association.
First impressions of Scott, what I thought I saw was a golden boy from Toronto that was raised with a silver spoon in his mouth, and I just didn't think our friendship and relationship would end up being what it is. I now know he's a redneck just like me, in an Armani suit.
What really struck me the most is how someone so young could be so heavily involved and so heavily connected in the industry.
He makes a lot of sense when he speaks.
Scott quickly established himself as a leader in the industry. In 2004, 2 years after his father passed, Scott became the youngest OTA chairman at 42 years old. During his tenure, he oversaw watershed changes in the industry, such as the effort to introduce speed limiters in Ontario and new Canadian hours of service rules. Among his innumerable contributions, Scott has served as chair of the OTA Convention Committee. He is the current chair of the OTA Education Foundation, a key board member on the Charitable Trucks for Change Network, and is the incoming chair of the Canadian Trucking Alliance.
I frankly, over the years, have wondered how Scott was able to run a business with all the work that he was doing on behalf of the association. And I think there's a lot of people in this room today who are should be very indebted to Scott for the battles he's fought and won on behalf of our industry.
At a fairly early age, Scott has accomplished a lot of things, many things that often people could look back on a longer career and say they did. He's done a lot of things. Often quietly behind the scenes, and sometimes front and center.
I know how proud Doug would be of Scott right now, not just of what he's done in the business, but in terms of his his contribution to this industry.
Over his career, Scott has been a powerful force for positive change in Ontario trucking. Schooled in the tradition that has sustained OTA over its history and with an impassioned eye set on the future, Scott Smith is imprinting his own legacy, one for the next generation to follow.
Scott, I just want to say I'm proud of you, my friend. We've come a long way together. I value your friendship. I value your leadership.
Scott, congratulations on winning this prestigious award. I can't think of anybody who is more deserving than you.
Congratulations. You've become a great friend, someone whom I deeply care for and look forward to a lot of years ahead of doing more of what we've already done.
Scott, I'm so happy for you today and so proud of you. I think of everything that you've given to your family, to your business, to your industry, and I can't think of anyone more deserving than you of receiving the Service to Industry Award. So congratulations. I know we're all proud of you and we're looking forward to see what comes next.